श्री कृष्णा श्री कृष्णा। गुरुर्ब्रह्मा गुरुर्विष्णु गुरुर्देवो महेश्वरः गुरु साक्षात् परम ब्रह्मा तस्मै श्री गुरवे नमः। तस्मै श्री गुरवे नमः। लेट अस रीड From verse number 14, Adhisthanam tatha karta karanam cha pruthak vidham vividhas cha pruthak cheshta daivam chaivatra panchamam sharira vangmanu bhiryata karma prarabhati naraham nyayam va viparitam va पञ्चैते तस्य हेतवः तत्रैवं सति कर्तारम् आत्मानं केवलं तु यः पश्यत्यकृतबुद्धित्वात् न स पश्यति दुर्मतिः। देर आर फाइव फैक्टर्स विच गो इन टू द परफॉर्मेंस ऑफ एनी एक्शन, whether the actions are done by the body, speech or the mind, whether the actions are good or bad. Tatraiva sati, this being so, meaning when the actions are attributed to these five factors performed through the body, speech and mind, tatraiva sati, atmanam kevalam kartaram yaha tu pashyati. Now, this particular verse has to be understood in two, three ways. Tatra prakrutena sambadhyate evam sati evam yathoktahi panchabihi hetubihi nirvarte sati karmani. When the things are done by these five factors, tatra teshu atmanam anannyatvena vidyaya avidyaya parikalpya तैहि क्रियमाणस्य कर्मणः अहम् एव कर्ता इति कर्तारम् आत्मानं केवलं शुद्धं तु या पश्यति अविद्वान्। द फर्स्ट मीनिंग इज ऑल्दो ऑल द कर्माज आर डन बाय दिस फाइव फैक्टर्स, हाउएवर तेषु आत्मानं अनन्यत्वेन अविद्यया परिकल्प्य अंडर द इन्फ्लुएंस ऑफ द इग्नोरेंस आइडेंटिफाइंग विथ अधिष्ठानं तथा कर्ता एटसेट्रा एंड तैहि क्रियमाणस्य कर्मणः, तो ऑल द कर्माज विच आर डन बाय द बॉडी स्पीच माइंड एटसेट्रा ऑफ दोज कर्म अहम एव कर्ता इति आत्मानं कर्तारं मन्यते एंड दस कंसिडर्स हिमसेल्फ टू बी द डूअर ऑफ ऑल द एक्शंस विच आर इन फैक्ट डन बाय द बॉडी स्पीच एंड द माइंड। नाउ इन दिस मैनर He who thinks he is a vidwan, he has not known anything. Kasmat Vedanta Acharya Upadesha Nyayaihi Akruta Buddhitvat Asanskruta Buddhitvat. Because he has not studied the Vedanta or the Shastra with the help of the Acharya, and therefore he does not have the faculty of study, understanding, appreciation, discrimination, knowledge about anything. And he is just living the life of mechanical existence. Now if you just look into your own life, don't go into other people's life, your own life. How many times we have sat quiet and observed this, or thought about it, that the body is doing something and that we take to be our doing, or the tongue or the speech is talking, then we start, I am talking, the eyes are seeing, we think that I am seeing. Now in this, when the example of seeing is taken, so in the seeing, what is happening? The seen object, the instrument of seeing, the eyes and the mind, and the seer which is born as a result of this action of seeing. Now all these three factors are clearly different from me, because when the seer is existing, all the three things are required. Seer by itself cannot exist independently without the seeing and the seen. So when the eyes are closed, there is no seen, there is no seeing, therefore there is no seer. But I continue to exist. So this Atma Tattva, Turiya Tattva, which is in fact not at all involved, influenced in the act of doing anything. Now to this Atma Tattva, when we become identified with the object, with the instrument of seeing and with the seer, the Vishwa, Taijasa, Prajna, then that mistaken understanding that I am the seer, experiencer, etc., na paschati akruta buddhitvat, because he has never thought in this line of contemplation. And then what he thinks, that aham eva karta, then I am the doer, I have done so much, but what is the result I got, you know. No, constantly complaining, disgusted, frustrated. This is one way of understanding. Meaning, the five factors are the doer, but when the I get identified with the five factors, I become the doer, etc. And that is considered as the real doer. So he has not understood, not seen. Now the second one. Yaha api dehadi vetirikta atmavadi. Now there is another person who thinks that I am other than the body. Deha adi. I am other than the body, speech and the mind. Yaha api dehadi vetirikta atmavadi anyam atmanam eva kevalam kartaram pashyati. असौ अपि अकृतबुद्धिः अत एव अकृतबुद्धित्वात् न स पश्यति आत्मनः तत्त्वं कर्मणो वा इत्यर्थः. नाउ दिस इज द सेकंड व्यू. सो द बॉडी, द स्पीच एंड माइंड, दे आर सेपरेट फ्रॉम द आत्मतत्व. एंड दिस नाउ पर्सन, ही थिंक्स दैट दिस आत्मा इज द वन who is doing everything through the body, through the mind, through the speech. And in this manner, although he has taken one step correct, recognize himself to be other than the body, speech and the mind, yet he has not understood that prakrute kriyamanani gune karmani sarvashaha. All the activities, modifications, they are happening in the prakruti. And Purusha is the Kutasthanitya. He is Akriya. He is not involved in any activity. And yet, to this Atma Tattva, which he has been able to appreciate as other than the body, speech, mind, this Atma is the doer. He who thus sees, he has neither known the Tattva, the essence of either the karma or the atma. Therefore, akrita buddhitvat na sa pashyati atmanah tattvam karmano va tattvam. He is neither able to see the essence of the karma, where the karma is and what the atma is. Ataha durmati hi. Therefore, he is durmati. तो दुर्मति कुच्छिता विपरीता दुष्टा अजस्रम जनन मरण प्रतिपत्ति हेतु भूता मति ही यस्य इति दुर्मति. वाई दुर्मति? बिकॉज ऑफ दिस रॉन्ग अंडरस्टैंडिंग. अजस्रम नॉन स्टॉप जनन मरण विप्रतिपत्ति हेतु भूता सती मति. तो हिज अंडरस्टैंडिंग मति इज द कॉज ऑफ the non-stop cycle of birth and death. And therefore he is called as Durmati. And he being Durmati, sa pashyan api na pashyati. Although he is seeing, he is not seeing. Means what? He is seeing the illusion, but he takes the illusion to be the real. So to see the illusion to be the real, it is not seeing, it is being blind. So, yatha taimirikaha anekam chandram, just like a person with a squint, he sees many suns, many moons, chandra. Yathava abreshu dhavasu chandram dhavantam. Or the ignorant child, when the clouds are running, he imagines that the moon is running in the clouds. Yathava vahane upavishtaha anneshu dhavasu atmanam dhavantam pashyati. Or when you are sitting in the car or a vehicle, you see the movement of the body or the vehicle superimposed on the road. In the same manner, although he is seeing, he does not see. This is how in this tatraiva satikartaram atmanam kevalam tuyaha pashyati akruta buddhitvan na sa pashyati sa durmatihi. He is a dull-witted one. Because of his own faults, he is suffering. So, kaha puna sumatihi yaha samyak pashyati iti. Now, when somebody is labeled as Durmati, then we want to know, where is Sumati? Or who is Sumati? Now, the Sumati is explained in the 17th sutra. Yasya naham kruto bhavo. Buddhir yasya na lipyate. Hatva pisa iman lokan.
Hatva pisa iman lokan.
Nahanti na nibadhyate.
Nahanti na nibadhyate.
Yasya, he whose shastra, acharya, upadesha, nyaya, sanskritat manaha. Who is this person? He who has the correct understanding about the panchaitani mahabaho, then sharira vagmano bhiryat karma prarabhate naraha. In this manner, he who has studied the scriptures under the instruction of the acharya, and therefore he has a clear understanding. This is this samasa. Shastra, acharya, upadesha, nyaya, sanskritatmanaha. Yasya is the sixth case. This is also the sixth case. Yasya, he who has this clear understanding, na bhavati ahankrutaha. He is not a ahankrita. What is ahankrita? Ahamkarta iti evam lakshano bhavo bhavana pratyaha ite eva panchadhisthana dayaha avidyaya atmani kalpitaha sarvakarmanam kartaraha na aham. So he has this clear understanding. What is that? Ahamkarta iti evam lakshana bhavaha pratyaya. I am the doer. This notion is and ete eva pancha dhishthana daya avidyaya atmani kalpita, and therefore this notion is only because of non-apprehension, superimposition of the modification of the deha etc. on the pure self through ignorance. Atmani kalpita, so sarva karmanam kartaraha, they are the doers, na aham, not me, not me. Then who am I? Aham tu tad vyaparanam sakshi bhutaha. But I am the mere witness of all the modifications of these panchamaha karanas, the five causes, the body, the speech and the mind. Aham tu tad vyaparanam sakshi bhutaha. Therefore, aprano yamana shubro yaksharat paratapparaha in the Munduko Manishad will be told. सो केवल अविक्रिय इति एवं पश्यति इति एतत्। सो ही रिकग्नाइजेस हिमसेल्फ टू बी अविक्रिय, द वन हु इज नॉट मॉडिफाइड बिकॉज ऑफ द मॉडिफिकेशन। कूटस्थ नित्य सपोर्ट्स ऑल द मॉडिफिकेशंस, like the space supports all the modifications of all the four elements, but doesn't get influenced by any one of them. That is why one of the techniques of meditation is to practice that gaganopamoham. In the Avadhut Gita, this is the meditation given. That I am space. So just play this game. Playing this game is meditation. Like now we are playing at this moment that I am the body. And when I take myself to be body, then everything in the gross world becomes real. Now this is only a game we are playing, then play another game now. So if I am body, what it means? Gross world is real. If the body is old, I am old. If the body is woman, I am woman. If the body is young, I am young. If the body has disease, I have diseases. This is how we are playing body-body. So playing body-body is jiva. Now playing space-space is sadhana, meditation, play. If I am space, means what? If I am body means what? I have a date of birth, I have growth, I have gender, I have shape, I have size, I have the possibility of death, I have enemies, I have diseases. This is playing body-body. Now play space. So, there is no shape, there is no size, there is no beginning, there is no end. See? This is meditation. Meditation is not a struggle. Never struggle. If you have learned something from me, you should not struggle in your life. The moment you struggle, you are going wrong. Spiritual practice is not a struggle. It's a joy. It's a fun. It's a great experience. So, tad vyaparanam sakshi bhutaha. I am the witness, uninfluenced by any one of them. Aprano, without any activity. Amanaha, without any knowledge, ignorance. Shubraha, Shubraha, it's not Shubho, Shubhro. He aksharat paratapparaha. So I am neither the gross body, the subtle body, the causal body, and therefore aksharat paratapparaha, I am beyond the three bodies. Keval akriyaha avikriyaha iti eva pashyati. In this manner he who sees himself, so yasya naham kruto bhavaha, this is the meaning. Now buddhihi yasya na lipyate. Buddhihi antakkaranam yasya atmanaha upadhi bhuta na lipyate. So yasya buddhi antakkaran, which is the upadhi of the atma, na lipyate, na anushayini bhavati, idam aham akarsham, tenaham, narakam gamishyami, iti evam yasya buddhihi na lipyate, sa sumatihi sa pashyati. Now he is understanding never takes this form. Which form? I have done this thing and because of that I will be going to the hell and I do not know. Means what? Buddhi yasya na lipyate means, here buddhi means understanding. His understanding is never clouded. It never carries the load of the arrogance of success and the guilt of failure. See? Buddhihi yasya na lipyate. There are no impressions on his buddhi, on his understanding about all the activities, because he says, he sees this. Yasya naham kruto bhavaha. Buddhihi yasya na lipyate. So two things. First is, his essential self is free from the doership. This he has recognized. Second thing, the conditioning through which he is functioning, that buddhi also does not get influenced by the activities, because there is no doership. When we have this notion that I have done something, then naturally the subsequent stage is the result of the karma. If I have done something, then I will get something, good or bad. But when the doership is rejected, buddhi yasya na lipyate saha sumati saha pashyati. He alone has a correct understanding and he alone sees. Now such a person, hatva api iman sarvan lokan sarvan praninaha ityartha. Hatva api, even if he happens to kill all the beings, that does not mean such a sumati goes on killing the people. So hatva api iman lokan sarvan praninaha na hanti. Hanana kriyam na karoti. So although he is killing, he is not a killer. Na anana kriyam karoti na nibadhyate na api tena karmana tatkarena adharma phalena sambadhyate. Killing is an act of sin, adharma, and yet he will not be touched by this adharma, the sin of killing. So hatva api sa iman lokan na hanti na nibadhyate. Now question is raised here. Hatva api na hanti iti vipratishiddham ucchate yadyapi stuti. We understand this is called as the arthavad. Such a person, even if he happens to kill the whole world, he is not influenced. That doesn't mean he kills. That means even the heinous act of killing does not create problem for him. So, but this is the kind of a contradiction, sir. Hatva api na hanti iti. Although he kills, he doesn't kill, means what? Vipratishiddham. It is a contrary statement. Although this is made to glorify such a Mahatma, but why this contradiction? Na esha doshaha. This is nothing wrong. You have to understand what? Laukika paramarthika drushti apekshaya tad upapattehe. Laukika drushti. The worldly man's vision is what? He has killed. And paramarthika drishti, from his own point of view, he knows that he has not killed anybody. This particular principle clicked me when I was in Tafragaon. I was staying in one of these quarters. Rains and all kinds of, you know, small insects and animals. When I was going to my room, stepping on the bricks, and I lifted one foot and put it, and my balance has completely gone on the next foot. And that time I realized that there is an insect. So I had no choice but to step, and my stepping killed that insect. So after that was done, I went to my room, then I started analyzing their experience. I said, I will feel very miserable. Oh, why did I kill that? I am so sorry, oh God, please forgive me and all this thing. That will happen. Second thing, who am I to kill anybody? Then guna gudeshu vartanta iti matvana sajjate. The moment the second point came in my mind, then I have not killed anything or anybody with any intention. Why should I feel bad about it? And therefore, whenever we live in this world, if we are clear about this knowledge, then we will neither have the guilt nor have the arrogance. If we are happen to be the cause of helping someone, it is happening in the prakriti. If we cannot help someone, it is happening in the Prakriti. Immediately the whole perspective of the life undergoes change. So Dehatma Buddhya Hantaham Iti Laukikim Drishti Mashritya Hatva Iti Aha. So from the worldly point of view, when Dehatma Buddhya, when somebody considers that I am the body, in that manner, yes, Laukiki Drishti, this is the worldly vision that I am the killer. And therefore Hatva it is said. And yatha darshitam paramarthikim drishtim ashritya. And as we have shown the paramarthiki drishti, shastra acharya upadesha naya sanskritatmanaha yasya ahankruto bhavaha nasti. He who doesn't have the I do the notion, for such a person, paramarthikim drishtim ashritya nahanti nanibadyate. So from the absolute standpoint, there is neither killing, therefore na hanti, na nibadyate, therefore no bondage. So, iti tad ubhayam upapadyate eva. And therefore, this is right. There is nothing wrong in saying this contradiction. Hatvapi sa iman lokan na hanti, na nibadyate. Now here, some question is taken. Nanu, adhisthanadi bihi sambhuja karoti eva atma, कर्तारम आत्मानम केवलम तु इति केवल शब्द प्रयोगान. नो हियर द क्वेश्चन इज रेज दैट व्हेन दिस स्टेटमेंट इज मेड दैट कर्तारम आत्मानम केवलम तु दैट ओनली द आत्मा इज नॉट डूइंग द कर्म व्हाट ही इज डूइंग द कर्म इन एसोसिएशन विद द पंच कारणानि हेतवः द फाइव कॉजेस. And therefore he is doing the karma. If this is said, then in this manner he is doing the karma. So, na esha doshaha. This is not wrong because atmanaha vikri avikriya svabhavatve adhisthanadibihi samhatatva anupapattehe. Atma being avikriya is without any change. And therefore, what is these five things? Adhishanam tathakrata karanam cha pratavidam. So, annehi samhananam sambhavati samhrutya. No. Avikriyatva swabhavatve adhishanavi samha anupapattehe. So, that which is constantly changing and that which is not changing, these two things can never come together. See? Space is never changing. And all the four elements are constantly changing. Therefore, the space can never be attached to the changes. In the same manner, these jagra, sapna, sushupta, purush, the avasthas, they are constantly changing. And this turiya tattva can never be touched by them. And therefore, atmanaha avikriya svabhavatve adhisthanadibihi samhatatva anupapatte. And therefore, those who think that Atma in association with these panchak karanani, he is the doer, that is also wrong. See, make it very clear. Because the question raised is, suppose we understand like this, that Atma in association with the five, he does the karma, what is wrong? No, that is also wrong. Why that is wrong? Because the unchanging, avikriya atma cannot be associated with the vikriya, the changing five factors. Because vikriya vato hi annehi samhananam sambhavati samhatyam va kartrutvam syad. Because vikaravan, vikriya vataha, the one which is constantly undergoing changes, annehi samhananam sambhavati, that alone can get associated with the other things and make a group. Samhananam sambhavati and samhutya va kartrutvam syat. And after that only the kartrutva is possible. Natu avikriyasya atmanaha kenaji samhananam asti. but this unmodifying, unchanging atma cannot be associated with anything. Iti na sambhuya kartrutvam upapadyate. And therefore, there cannot be doership in this atma in association with the adhisthanam tathakarta, etc. Ataha kevalatvam atmanah swabhavikam. Iti kevala shabda anuvadamatra. So here the word kevalam atmanam, here the word kevala is to very clearly understand that the kevala is that one which is one without a second, where there are no differences, where there is no otherness. And therefore the shuddha atma tattva can never be associated with any doing. So what are the things that we have to understand? The panchaitani mahabaho karanani nimodave. So these five adhisthanam tathakarta, they are responsible for all the karma done through the body, speech and mind. This being so, those who mistake that the atma in association with them do the karma, that is wrong. Why? Because atma cannot be associated with the changing, because atma tattva is unchanging. Second thing, only the atma is doing the karma. That is also wrong, because atma is akarta abhokta. And therefore, ataha kevalam atma atmanaha or atmanam is only swabhavikam. This kevalatva of the self is natural. It is not something which is specially said about the atma. Avyakriyatvam chatmanaha shruti smriti nyaya prasiddham. The atma is free from any modifications of doer, etc. This is always established in the scriptures such as the Upanishad and the Gita, etc. Therefore, avikaryo yamuchate gunereva karmani kriyante sharirasthopi na karoti ityadi asatkrut upapaditam gitasu eva tavat. This was said again and again in Bhagavad Gita, here and there. Shruti shucha dhyayati iva lelayati iva iti evam adhyasu. And also in the Chandogya Upanishad, as if he is doing meditation, as if meditation means thinking, as if he is thinking, as if he is doing. So as if, not actually. So nyayatahata, so we are taken shruti smruti. Now the third praman is the nyaya, the logic. Nyayataha nir avayavam aparatantram avikriyam atma tattvam iti rajamargaha. So logically it is so simple that nir avayavam, avayavam, that which does not have the limb. Now see, on the basis of this, I think I told you one story about this Birbal and Akbar, where Akbar asked Birbal that your God is superior or I am superior. So Birbal said, sir, you are superior, not God. How come? He said, because when you become angry, you can throw somebody out of your kingdom. When God becomes angry, he cannot throw him out of his kingdom. So who is superior? What he meant was that your kingdom is limited. God's kingdom is unlimited. Nothing can be thrown out of God's kingdom. Therefore, here also, nir avayavam, that which is all-pervading, aparatantra, independent, avikriyam, the without modification, atma-tattvam, iti rajamargaha. This is the royal path. Hold on to this. All other things are only the tragic paths. Vikriya vatva abhyupagame api atmanaha svakiya eva vikriya svasya bhavitum arhati. Now, even if we, for the sake of argument, when we consider the atma to be with the modification, so his modification will be with himself, not with others. So, na adhisthana dina karmani atma kartrukani siyuhu. Therefore, the changes, the modification of the five factors, adhisthana, tatha, karta, they can never ever belong to this atma-tattva. Because, nahi parasya karma parena akrutam agantum arhati. So when something is done by somebody, why do you impose it on yourself? Yattu avidya gamitam na tattasya. And whatever is recognized, gained, known through ignorance, it doesn't belong to him. Yatha rajatattva na shuktikayaha. Like the silveriness never belong to the shell. Yathava talamalavatvam balaihi gamitam avidyaya na akashasya. Similarly, the space being the blue and like a dome, this is for the kids, not for the wise, and this is by for the kids because avidyaya, only by avidya gamitam, is known because of the ignorance about the space. Tatha adhisthanadi vikriya api tisham eva iti na atmanaha. And therefore, all these kriya of the adhisthana tathakrata, they belong to only to the ignorant people's understanding, or they belong to only adhisthanam tathakrata. These five factors, never they belong to the atma tattva. Tasmad yuktam uktam. Therefore, rightly said that ahankritva buddhi lepa abhavat vidvan nahanti na nivadhyate. Therefore, in the absence of the doership and in the absence of the involvement of the buddhi by the action, good or bad, it was rightly said that nahanti na nivadhyate. Neither he kills nor he is influenced by the act of killing. Now here the teacher concludes, Nayam hanti na hanyate iti pratijnaya, in the second chapter, if you remember. In the second chapter, Bhagavan says, Ubhautau na vijanitaha nayam hanti na hanyate. He who thinks that somebody is killing and somebody is killed, Ubhautau na vijanitaha, both of them do not know. So from there we started in the second chapter. Nayam hanti na hanyate iti pratijnaya. Then the second hetu, the cause was given. What is the cause? Na jayate mriyate va vipaschit nayam bhutva bhavita vanabhuya. And in this manner, by this, avikriyatvam atmanaha uktva. And there it was proved that atma tattva is without any vikriya, without any modification, without any change. And Veda Vinashinam iti vidushaha karma adhikara nivruttim shastradau sankshepataha uktva. And therefore, he who knows this atma tattva, which is avinashi without any modification, for him there is no more karma to be done left in this world. And in this manner, shastradau sankshepataha uktva, the essence of the scriptures having been told in short, madhye prasaritacha, and in between chapters, this same thing was explained and expounded and expanded. Tatra tratra prasangam krutva iha upasamharati. So bringing this topic in the various contexts, now in this 18th chapter, this whole thought of the Upanishad is summarized in the Gita, and now also in this 18th chapter, krutva iha, in this 18th chapter, upasamharati, shastrartha pindikaranaya, for the assimilation of the total meaning of the scriptures in one small little thing, vidvan nahanti iti nivadyate. What is the conclusion? Even if the wise man is seen to be killing others, he never kills anyone. This is how, because he never kills anyone, he is never bound by the act of killing. Now, evam cha sati, this being so, deha bhrutva bhimana anupapattau avidyakruta ashesha karma sannyasa upapattehe sannyasinam anishtadi trividam karmanaha phalam na bhavati iti. Now this being so, evam cha sati means what the earlier paragraph. Because the wise person is never the killer and therefore not influenced by the act of killing. Therefore, deha bhrutvadi abhimana anupapattau, he who does not have the identification with the body as I am the body, etc., born out of the ignorance, and therefore ashesha karma sannyasa upapattehe, फॉर हिम देर इज डेफिनेटली ए पॉसिबिलिटी ऑफ रिनन्सिएशन ऑफ ऑल द कर्म अशेष विदाउट एनीथिंग. सो सच सन्यासी नाम फॉर सच सन्यासी अनिष्टादि त्रिविधम कर्मणा फलम न भवति. फॉर सच सन्यासी त्रिविधम भवति कर्मणा फलम. दिस थ्री काइंड ऑफ कर्म इष्टम अनिष्टम मिश्रम च दीज आर नॉट मेंट फॉर दी सन्यासी इति उपपन्नम. दिस इज नेचुरली प्रूड तद विपर्ययाच इतरेषां भवति इति. एंड देयरफॉर दोज हु हैव नॉट गिवन अप द बॉडी आइडेंटिफिकेशन द सेंस ऑफ डुअरशिप देयर माइंड इज ऑलवेज इन्फ्लुएंस्ड बाय एवरीथिंग दैट दे डू और डोंट डू तेषां इतरेषां त्रिविधः कर्मणं फलं भवति इति. एतत् च अपरिहार्यम् इट इज बट नेचुरल इट कैनॉट बी स्टॉप इति एष गीता शास्त्रस्य अर्थः उपसंहृतः. दिस इज हाउ द कंक्लूजन ऑफ ऑल द सिद्धांत द एसेंस द डॉक्ट्रिन ऑफ भगवद गीता. सी नाउ देयर कैनॉट बी एनी बेटर प्रेजेंटेशन देन दिस. सो एज लॉन्ग एज वी आर लिविंग एज अ विश्व तेजस प्राज्ञ यू कंटिन्यू टू लिव एज द जीवा एंड सफर. एंड वेन वी कम टू डायग्नोज अवर आइडेंटिटी देन आई एम द तुरीय तत्व सपोर्टिंग द तत्वस्य अग्रहणम अन्यथा ग्रहणम वा द नॉन एप्रिहेंशन एंड मिस एप्रिहेंशन ऑफ द ट्रूथ दैट रियालिटी तुरीय तत्व आई एम. When this is recognized, he is a real sannyasi. And for such a sannyasi, sarva karma phalatyagaha or renunciation of all the vidushaha karma adhikara nivruttim, he has given up all the karma and therefore it is ashesha karma sannyasa is possible. And therefore, this topic, who will be influenced by the karma phala, the three types, is only for the ignorant and not for the wise. Esha eva sarva vedartha saraha. Now this is the essence of all the Vedas. Nipuna matibihi panditaihi vicharya. So by those who have got proper understanding, wisdom, having vicharya, having thought of, प्रतिपत्तव्यः इति तत्र तत्र प्रकरण विभागेन दर्शितः अस्माभिः शास्त्र न्यायानुसारेण. एंड दिस पर्टिकुलर थिंग विच इज टू बी एक्सेप्टेड बाय द वाइज पीपल वी हैव शोन इन दिस कमेंट्री ऑन भगवद गीता इन द राइट कंटेक्स्ट. सो दैट शुड बी सीन एंड प्रैक्टिस बाय द सिंसियर सीकर्स ऑफ ट्रूथ. आफ्टर हैविंग सेड दिस अथ इदानीं कर्मणां प्रवर्तकम् उच्यते. सो अप टू द 17 चैप्टर वर्स नाउ वन समरी ऑफ द टोटल स्क्रिप्चरल नॉलेज इज गिवन. नाउ फ्रॉम द 18th वर्स ऑनवर्ड द टीचर टेक्स अप अनदर थीम. अथ इदानीं कर्मणां प्रवर्तकम् उच्यते. नाउ हियर टू अंडरस्टैंड क्लियरली द होल सीक्रेट अबाउट द कर्म the teacher now says who is or what is that because of which the karma is taken, undertaken, the karma is done. This is said in the 18th verse. Jnanam jneyam parijnata trividha karma chodana करणं कर्म कर्तेति त्रिविध कर्म संग्रहः ज्ञानं ज्ञायते अनेन इति सर्वविषयं अविशेषेण उच्यते. ज्ञानं मीन्स अ कॉमन थिंग अ नॉलेज अविशेषेण उच्यते. वी आर नॉट टॉकिंग अबाउट नॉलेज ऑफ समथिंग ऑर नॉलेज इन जनरल. तथा ज्ञेयम् ज्ञातव्यम् तत् अपि सामान्येन एव सर्वम् उच्यते. सो In common, the knowledge, jnaya, jnatavya, that is known, anything that is known, sarvam uchyate, then tatha paridnyata, so also the knower, upadhi lakshanaha, avidya kalpito bhokta iti, so the one who is identified with the conditioning, and therefore he has become the knower, enjoyer, so etat trayam eshanam, avisheshena sarvakarmanam pravartika, त्रिविधा त्रि प्रकारा कर्मचोदना सो दिस इज द थ्री फैक्टर्स विच गो विच विल प्रॉम्प्ट इनिशिएट एनी कर्म नाउ टू अंडरस्टैंड दिस सी फर्स्ट थिंग इज जानाति आई नो समथिंग दैट सच एंड सच थिंग इज अवेलेबल देयर आफ्टर इच्छति Then we desire that. Thereafter, karoti, we do the karma. So, where from it started? It started from janati. So, the knowledge is the karma chodana. The knowledge is the one which is the prompter of all the karma. Without the knowledge of something, we will never be prompted to do something. Like, you know, when the seekers are on the spiritual path in the initial stages, they hear things about some Mahatmas and then immediately, oh, such and such Mahatma is there, you know, and it's a great Mahatma. Acha, I'll go and there. So the moment Jnanam has taken place, then I want to go and visit there. And after visiting there, then you feel, you know, oh, this is what it is. I thought, you know, something different. So first, jnanam, neya paridnyata. Three. So jnana jnanam hi trayanam sannipate hanopanadi prayojana sarva karmarambha syat. So when these three things, sannipate, when these three things come together, ज्ञानम नेयम परिज्ञाता देन हान उपादान आदि प्रयोजनः सर्व कर्मारंभः ऑल द अंडरटेकिंग्स आइदर ऑफ टेकिंग और रिसीविंग और गिविंग अप और रनिंग और हगिंग ऑल काइंड्स ऑफ कर्म बिगिन ओनली आफ्टर दिस थ्री फैक्टर्स कम टुगेदर नाउ ततः पंचभिः अधिष्ठानादिभिः आरब्धं वाङ् मन कायाशय भेदेन त्रिधा राशिभूतं त्रिषु कर्णादिषु संगृह्य इति एतदुच्यते नाउ व्हाट वाज सेड अर्लियर दैट पंचैतानि महाबाहो कारणानि निमोदमे एंड देन इट वाज टोल्ड दैट अधिष्ठानं तथा कर्ता करणं च पृथक्विदं विविधा च पृथक् चेष्टा दैवं चैवात्र पंचमं नाउ दिस फाइव फैक्टर्स तत्र पंचभी अधिष्ठानादिभिः आरब्धम् फ्रॉम देयर स्टार्टिंग देन वांग मन काय आश्रय भेदेन नाउ विद द हेल्प ऑफ दिस थ्री फैकल्टीज कॉल्ड एज द बॉडी स्पीच एंड माइंड त्रिधा राशि भूतम क्लासिफाइड अंडर द थ्री हेड्स त्रिषु कर्णादिषु ऑल दिस थ्री थिंग्स इंस्ट्रूमेंट्स आर संग्रह्यते आर दे आर नाउ ब्रॉट टुगेदर इन करणम So, karanam karma karteti. So, karanam includes all these things. The sharir vang mana and the panche mani karanani nivodhame. So, all of them are put together into one word. Is karanam. Kriyate anena iti bayam shrotradi antastam buddhyadi. Is karanam. Then second is karma ipsitatamam kartuhu kriyayaha vyaptamanam vyapyamanam. Then karma is that in English we can call karma means undertaking. So all the undertakings are called as karma because it is kriyaya vyapyamanam kartuhu ipsitatamam that which is desired like by the doer. So the undertaking. Karta, karananam vyaparayita upadhi lakshanaha. Karta is the one who is using the various faculties such as the body, speech, mind, etc. Iti trividaha tri prakaraha karma sangraha. In this manner, these three things put together are responsible for the conduct of any undertaking. So now what is the total thought? Total thought is jnanam, neyam, parijnata. These are the promptings behind any undertaking. And karanam, karma, karta. These are the three how the undertaking is conducted. So these two together, one is jnana pradhan, second is karma pradhan. When these two things come together, then only any undertaking takes place. So sangruyate asmin iti sangraha karmanaha sangra karma sangraha. Where everything is put together into one capsule is called as sangraha. So karma eshu trishu samavaiti tena ayam trividaha karma sangraha. So karma is done with the help of these three things put together. Therefore, karanam karma karta, this is called as karma sangraha. Now, atha idanim kriyakaraka phalanam sarvesham gunatmakatvat radastha sattva radastamo guna bhedata trivido bhedo vaktavya iti arambhyate. Now, all these things, kriyakaraka phala, in all the undertaking, what are the things? One is kriya, second is karaka, the doer, and phala, the result. So every karma has got these three aspects. So all of them are sarvesham gunatmakatvat. All of them fall in the purview of the prakriti's three gunas. And therefore, they are divided into the sattvic, rajasic, and tamasic. Guna bhedataha, depending upon the predominance of the one particular guna. And this is, what are their differences? This is worthy of telling. And therefore, Bhagavan Sri Krishna begins this topic. Jnanam karma cha karta cha.
Jnanam karma cha karta cha.
Tridhaiva guna bhedataha. Prochate guna sankhyane.
Prochate guna sankhyane.
Yathavat shrulutanyapi.
Yathavat shrulutanyapi.
Jnanam karma cha karta cha. Tridhaiva guna bhedataha. Depending on the gunas bheda, differences, this jnana, karma and karta, they are divided into three each. So there will be three types of jnanam, three types of karma, and three types of karta, the doer. Prochyate guna sankhyane yathava shrunutanyapi, told by the Sankhya Shastra, what it is, we'll tell you, listen now. This is in general translation. Before we go to Bhagavan Shankara's commentary, one very important point which troubles every student. In the 18th verse, six factors were told. Jnanam neyam parijnata and karanam karma karta. Six. But Bhagavan is telling, on the basis of the gunas, only jnanam karma cha karta cha. As if karana is not made out of three gunas or what? Karana is also made out of three gunas. So jnanam is told, then karma is told, and karta is told. So from the karma chodana, from the promptings of the karma, jneya and parijnata is rejected. That is not said to be divided in three gunas. Similarly, karanam of the karma sangraha, the second line, that is also not taken for discussion. So what do we understand? Now keep this question in your mind, and as we unfold slowly, slowly, this question will explain you when it comes in the right place. Then we'll come to know that all the six factors are included in this word, kriyakaraka phalanam. Kriyakaraka and the phala. All of them are trigunatmika. How it is, what it is, when it comes into that particular area of the shloka, I'll explain you. It is this, it is that. Then you will never forget it. Now come to the Bhagavan Shankara's commentary. He says, Jnanam karma cha, karma kriya, na karaka paribhashikam ipsitatamam karma. Now here the word karma means the action, and not the karma means like, you know, the nominative case, accusative case, the instrumental case. So this cases in Sanskrit is called as karaka, isn't it? Karaka pratyaya. So here the karma does not mean that the second accusative case, no. Therefore karma kriya na karakam paribhashikam ipsitatamam karma. Like, you know, ramaha vanam gacchati. So here vanam has become the karma grammatically. So here jnanam karma cha karta cha. So here the word karma does not mean the karma as meant by the grammar. Then what it is? Karma kriya. It is called as action. Karta cha nivartakaha. Nirvartakaha. The one who, nirvartakaha kriyanam. The one who is conducting all the activities, he is called as the karta. Jnanam is left as jnanam, karma cha karta cha. त्रिधा एव अवधारणम गुण व्यतिरिक्त जात्यांतर अभाव प्रदर्शनार्थम. एंड देयरफॉर जात्यांतर अभाव प्रदर्शनार्थम अदर देन दिस थ्री गुणा देयर इज नो पॉसिबिलिटी. देयरफॉर गुण व्यतिरिक्त जाति अंतर अभाव अदर देन द थ्री कैटेगरीज देयर इज नो फोर्थ कैटेगरी पॉसिबल. एंड देयरफॉर त्रिधा एव द वर्ड त्रिधा एव Tridhaiva means Tridhaiva. So there is no fourth classification of these three types of jnanam, three types of karma and three types of karta. There is nothing like jnanam is of five types, karma is of two types and the karta is of seven types. No. All of them are only three, three each. Therefore Tridhaiva, avadharana. Eva means emphasis. So this is how emphasize that only three types. Now, गुणभेदतः सत्वादि भेदेन इत्यर्थः. अकॉर्डिंग टू द थ्री गुणा सत्व रजस तमस प्रोच्यते कथ्यते दे आर टोल्ड अगेन पैसिव वॉइस को टोल्ड बाय होम गुण संख्याने कापिले शास्त्रे. सो कपिल मुनि सांख्य शास्त्र ऑन द बेसिस ऑफ विच द पतंजलि मुनि योग शास्त्र इज बेस्ड दैट कापिले शास्त्रे. नाउ हियर भगवान शंकरदास कॉमेंट्री. तद अपि गुण संख्यानम शास्त्रम गुण भोक्तृ विषय प्रमाणम एव परमार्थ ब्रह्म एकत्व विषये यद्यपि विरुध्यते. सी देयरफॉर दिस सांख्य शास्त्र ऑफ द कपिल मुनि इज परफेक्टली ऑल राइट व्हेन वी एक्सेप्ट गुण भोक्तृ विषये. व्हेन वी टॉक अबाउट द जीवा, who is the bhokta of the jiva, gunas, is the jiva. So about the jiva, this shastra is pramanam, the final authority. However, paramartha brahma ekatva vishaye yadyapi viruddhate. But here we do not accept this Kapila's sankhya shastra as regards the non-dual absolute reality is concerned, where brahmatmaikya bodha is the ultimate. तेही कापिला गुण गौण व्यापार निरूपणे अभियुक्ता. अभियुक्ता मीन्स एक्सपर्ट्स. सो दीस कापिला मीन्स दोज फॉलोअर्स ऑफ द कपिल ऋषि, द सांख्य शास्त्रज्ञ, द योगीज. सो दोज कापिला गुण गौण व्यापार निरूपणे अभियुक्ता, दे आर एक्सपर्ट इन डिस्क्राइबिंग एंड टॉकिंग एंड एक्सप्लेनिंग अबाउट द थ्री गुणाज ऑफ द प्रकृति एटसेट्रा. तत् शास्त्रम अपि वक्षमाण अर्थ स्तुत्यत्वेन उपादीयते इति न विरोधः. एंड देयरफॉर दिस शास्त्र इज एक्सेप्टेड एज द अथॉरिटी फॉर द वक्षमाण अर्थ, फॉर व्हाट इज टू बी टोल्ड फॉर दैट टॉपिक. दिस कपिलास कपिलास सांख्य शास्त्र इज द अथॉरिटी एंड देयरफॉर इज एक्सेप्टेड. यथावत यथा न्यायम यथा शास्त्रम. Whatever is told exactly the same way we will tell you. Shrunu tani api. So kindly listen to them. Jnanadini tad bheda jatani guna bheda krutani shrunu vakchamani arthe manas samadhim kuru ityartha. So now we are going to tell the clear classification of the three types of jnana, the three types of karma, the three types of karma, and some more three threes, which is based on the authority of the Kapila Muni, Sankhya Shastra, because they are expert in dealing with the relative existence or the jivas coming and going and all that. This is how you know this particular path attracts more people. Like what? When there is some Mahatma who has done a lot of spiritual practice, and what is spiritual practice? He has controlled Prakriti. When the Prakriti is controlled, he has all the siddhis. And because of the siddhis, he is able to help somebody, etc. So he is a great Mahatma. Now what is the foundation for that Mahatma? Foundation is, I am Siddha Purusha, and then I will like to grow spiritually, I can bless the whole world by my powers and all that. So I versus the world, this duality remains. Up to here they can go. And then they talk about the Siddha Loka, and there is a Bhavar Gufa, and there are, you know, this Sutala, Tala, Vitala, Talatala, Mahatala, Rasatala, Patala. And then there is Bhurbhuvasva, Mahajana, Tapasatyam. And in this Chaturdasha Bhuvanani, there they are completely, totally lost. And they are expert in this field. But when it comes to Paramartha Brahma Ekatva Vishaya, there they are not acceptable to us. Therefore, Tad Bheda Jatani Guna Bheda Kritani Shudu Vakshamani Arthe. Kindly listen. What are the differences? Manas Samadhim Kuru. That means focus your attention fully on this topic so that you do not misunderstand and go the wrong way. Jnanasya tu tava trividatvam uchyate. Now first we talk about the jnanam, the three types of jnanam. Sarva bhuteshu ye naikam.
Sarva bhuteshu ye naikam.
Bhavam avyayam ikshate.
Bhavam avyayam ikshate.
Avibhaktam vibhakteshu.
Avibhaktam vibhakteshu.
Tajnanam vidhi sattvikam.
Tajnanam vidhi sattvikam.
Sarvabhuteshu avyaktadi sthavaranteshu bhuteshu yena jnanena ekam bhava vastu bhava shabdo vastu vachi ekam atmatattva atma vastu ityartha. So that knowledge by which sarvabhuteshu, in all the things and beings, see, sarvabhuteshu avyaktadi sthavaranteshu. So all the things and beings, starting from the prakriti up to the grass of blade, sarvabhuteshu yena jnanena, by that knowledge, ekam bhavam vastu. Vastu means the reality. So there is one reality which is seen. Means what? Ekam atma vastu ityartha. So that knowledge by which we are able to see that one reality pulsating in and through the total creation, and it is none other than the I, that knowledge by which this is seen, that knowledge is called as sattvika jnanam. So sarva bhuteshu yenekam bhavam avyamikshate. Therefore the path of knowledge is not talking about the differences, not talking about the divisions, but seeing the one in spite of the many. So sarva bhuteshu avyaktadi sthavaranteshu bhuteshu yena jnanena ekam bhavam vastu bhava shabdo vastu vachi ekam atma vastu ityartha. Now avyayam na veti svatmana dharmaihi kutastha nityam ityartha. Avyayam means that which does not modify, doesn't leave its own essential nature. Therefore, kutastha nitya, ever the same. Ityartha, ikshate yena jnanena paschati. So he, not he, that knowledge by which the unchanging support of the total changing world is recognized is called as the Sattvic Jnanam. Now, Tamcha Bhavam, now that absolute reality which is supporting all the differences, Tamcha Bhavam, Avibhaktam Pratideham Vibhakteshu Devabedeshu, Vibhaktam Tad Atma Vastu Vyomavat Nirantaram, Na Vibhaktam Tad Atma Vastu Vyomavat Nirantaram. So, Avibhaktam Deham Prati, or Pratideham, this Atma Tattva is not divided because of the bodies. Now see the basic difference in the Sankhya Yoga and our Vedanta Shastra or Bhagavad Gita. So, Tam Bhavan Avibhaktam Pratideheshu Vibhakteshu Deheshu. So, although the bodies are many, but there are not many Atmas, many Jivas. There is but one reality. Na Vibhaktam Tad Atma Vastu Vyomavat Nirantaram Eva. Like the space, it is one without a second, undivided. Taj Jnanam Advaita Atma Darshanam Sattvikam Samyak Darshanam Vidhi Iti. That knowledge is called as Advaita Atma Darshanam, the non-dual recognition of the self. That knowledge is called as Sattvikam Jnanam. All others are only Rajasic and the Tamasic. So, Yani Dvaita Darshanani Asamyak Bhutani Rajasani Tamasani Chaiti Na Sakshat Samsara Uchittaye Bhavanti. Now see, this knowledge alone is responsible for transcending the relative existence. And Dvaita Darshanani, what is the Dvaita Darshan? The total manifest world falls in the Dvaita Darshan. So in this duality or the relative existence, which is Asamyak Bhutani, this is not the ultimate absolute knowledge. So which are those Rajasani, Tamasani? These are the two types of knowledges, Rajas and Tamas. Na Sakshar Samsara Uchittaye Bhavanti. They are not the ultimate medicine for liberation from the relative existence and discovery of the absolute being. This is the Sattvic Jnana. Now what is the Rajasic Jnanam? Pruthaktvena tu yajnanam Nana bhavan pruthakvidhan Vetti sarveshu bhuteshu Tajnanam viddhi rajasam Pruthaktvena tu bhedena prati shariram anyatvena. See, per body there is a separate atma. Pruthaktvena bhedena prati shariram anyatvena yajnanam nana bhavan bhinnan atmanaha pruthakvidhan pruthak prakaran bhinna lakshanan ityartaha. So that knowledge by which we recognize the manyness of the jivas, and per body there is one jiva in this manner, and each jiva is separate from the other, bhinna lakshanan, vetti vijanati yajnanam sarveshu bhuteshu. So in all the beings there are different jivas separate from each other, one has to do nothing with the other. So jnanasya kartrutva sambhavad yena jnanena vetti ityartaha. Jnana is not the doer, therefore by that knowledge which one knows. So that knowledge because of which one knows only the differences and the different jivas, that knowledge is called as Rajasic Jnanam, Rajo Nirvruttam. It is under the influence of the Rajoguna. Because Rajoguna is what? Rajoguna is the field where activity is. And activity is possible only in the field of duality. If there is only the eyes, no thing to see, color and form, then there is no activity possible. Or if there are only the things and nobody to see that, then no activity is possible. So rajas or the rajoguna is responsible for all the activity. And that which is giving birth to the activity is the bheda drishti, the otherness, the separateness, and therefore that knowledge is called as rajasik jnanam. Now the third knowledge is the tamasik one. Yattu krishnavade kasmin karye saktamahaitukam atatvarthavadalpancha tattamasamudarutam. Now yattu jnanam, actually you know in this verse Bhagavan Shankara has written jnanam, but Bhagavan Sri Krishna has not said it as jnanam. See, there is no word jnanam in this. In the sattvik, tas jnanam sattvikam. Rajasik, tas jnanam vidhi rajasam. When it came to tamasik, nowhere the word jnanam is used, because it is ajnanam. It is not jnanam at all. So, yattu jnanam krishnavad, samastavad, sarva vishayam iva, ekasmin arthe, or ekasmin karye, देहे बहिवा प्रतिमादौ सक्तम एतावानेव आत्मा ईश्वरो वा न तहा परमस्ति इति यथा नग्न क्षपणकादीनां शरीरानुवर्ती देह परिमाणो जीव ईश्वरो वा पाषाण दार्वादि मात्र एव इति एकस्मिन् कारे सक्तम. नाउ दैट नॉलेज बिकॉज ऑफ विच कृष्णवत एज इफ एवरीथिंग इज ओनली दिस मच. व्हाट इज दैट? एकस्मिन् कारे. So only one thing is considered to be everything, such as dehe. They think that the body is everything, nothing beyond that. Or bahiva, or outside, pratimadau, that particular idol of the god, that alone is the real god. Saktam, they are extremely attached. And etavan eva atma ishvarova. And for them, this is the understanding. Only the body, and within the body, whatever, that alone is the Atma. Or that particular idol of the God, that alone is the Ishvara. Beyond that, there is no Ishvara. In this manner, ataha na paramasti, there is nothing beyond this. Yatha nagnak shapanakadi naam, sharuranuvarti deha parimano jivaha. So those who are at Digambar Jain, they have this understanding. Atma is of the size of the body and there is nothing beyond that. And similarly, those who are the followers of, you know, this devotion to the Lord, hold on to one particular idol or the form and they think this alone is the Ishvara. So, Pashana Darvadi Matra Evam, either the stone or the wooden piece, that alone is considered as everything. So, Evam Ekasmin Karye Saktam. They are extremely attached to this limited understanding of the unlimited reality. Ahetukam, what is the logic behind it? There is no logic. See, ahetukam. Hetu varjitam niryuktikam. There is no logic behind it. And a tatvarthavat. Yatha bhutaha arthaha tatvarthaha. Saha yasya dneya bhutaha asti iti tatvarthavat. Na tatvarthavat a tatvarthavat. Ahetukatvat eva. A tatvartham, it means not as it is. So, their understanding is not based on any logic and it is not as it is. And a hetukatvat being illogical, alpam cha, alpa vishayatvat, alpa phalatvat, and it is concerning the limited understanding and the limited results. Tat tamasam udharutam, that is called as the tamasik jnanam. Tamasanam hi praninam avivekinam idrisham jnanam drishyate. Those who are ignorant, for them alone, this kind of ignorant knowledge is seen. This is how, these are the three types of knowledges, which is sattvic, rajasic and tamasic. Now hereafter, we will be doing the three types of karma in our next class. ओम पूर्णमदः पूर्णमिदं पूर्णात् पूर्णमुदच्यते पूर्णस्य पूर्णमादाय पूर्णमेवावशिष्यते। ओम शांति शांति शांति। हरि ओम श्री गुरुभ्यो नमः। हरि ओम।